Josh?
Yeah, it certainly doesn't take much for gas prices to creep up these days, and it certainly doesn't inspire confidence as to where these prices are now headed. And while it's definitely a painful whack to the wallet for most of us, it's also the end of the road for one longtime business in Goffstown.
Another day, another spike in the price of gas, and of course, frustration at the pump.
I think it's a lot of money.
Sad. We've got all that oil coming out of Canada now, which we could take good advantage of.
But while customers complain about the cost of gas, it's all costing John Sylvain much more.
I just want to sell gas. That's all I wanted to do.
For roughly 15 years, John has run a gas-only station that has operated on Main Street in Goffstown since the 1940s, a neighborhood business where the customers are more like friends.
Even if I was low on cash, he'd fill my tank, I'd catch him later. I mean, where can you go to get that?
It's not busy. I hang around and shoot the breeze with him, you know. I had a pleasure meeting his family, and he is like family, you know.
But without the convenience store wares of potato chips and sodas to augment his income, the 14 cents he makes on a gallon of gas just isn't enough these days.
Well, you know, for 2 cents, a customer goes someplace else. Maybe a penny even.
Despite his loyal customers, John has seen his business drop 60% in about a year. So he's decided once his tanks are empty, his customers will have to go elsewhere to fill theirs. John figures in the next day or so, that will be it.
I'm sorry, I have to give it up. I loved it.
Well, it seems that gas prices just might become a bigger issue on the presidential race as well. The candidates certainly talking more about them than they have in the past. And in Michigan, by the way, which holds its primary in just 8 days, the price of a gallon of gas spiked 30 cents over the weekend in some areas of that state. Ouch. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.